Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Comic Book Club. I'm Alex.
Peter.
And Justin is still away, but we got three awesome...
He's still drunk.
Yeah, he's still drunk, you guys. It's been a 2 to 3 day bender.
Yeah. We had an intervention with him, so he's a little upset, but...
Yeah, unfortunately, we brought alcohol to the intervention, which seemed like a little bit of a mistake at the time.
Yeah.
And continues to seem like a mistake. But let's talk about comic books. We're going to talk about Scar number 11, Sea Guy, Slaves of Mickey Eye number 3, and Black Panther number 5. So let's get into it and talk about Scar number 11. Pete, you've been a big fan of the series. If you're a big fan of fellow goatee wearer Greg Pak.
Well, yeah. I mean,
so what do you think of this issue?
Well, here's the thing. There isn't a bigger fan of Greg Pak than me. I mean, maybe
I said that guy.
But the problem I'm having with this is Scar is a fantastic possibility for a character. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's issue 11, we still don't know who he is. You know what I mean? Right. Like, he's just a victim of circumstance still. You know what I mean? Where, he hasn't known his dad, his mom's giving him weird lessons and messing with his head, and, like, he lashes out all the time, and we just don't know who he is, and that kind of bothers me a little bit. And, like, there's just been so much going on in the world of, like, oh, it's fighting his dad. Oh, that wasn't really his dad. Oh, he's the Silver Surfer now. No, that's not true. His mom is somehow can be alive for certain parts. And then his world blows up, and it's like, I just wish that there was a little bit more time to deal with everything. That being said, I think it's a great character. I think it's the writing is good. I want more, and I want like be able to feel some moments. You know, it's just stuff happening.
Very quickly, because that was the most coherent, consistent thing I think I've ever heard you say. It was really, really. I totally agree completely with all your points. I do think this current arc is the best in the series history. It simplified everything by bringing Scar to Earth. I love the new twist that Scar has a banner self of his own, basically.
Yeah. But there was a weird moment in that where they're like, Scar's dead. And you're like, no, he just turned into a human form and you can't pick him up. And they're like, oh, God, I wonder if we'll ever be able to find him. And then, like, the next panel, he's Scar again. And they're like, oh, there he is. I was like, why do we go through all that?
I don't know. I'm enjoying this current arc, personally.
Yeah.
I do think... Everything that you're saying, Scar is very much like Rolk right now, where all they do is spend time talking about, like, well, I've got a plan, and that they're, like, ultra cool and can beat up anybody. And yeah. That's pretty much what they've got going for them. I think Scar has more potential, personally.
Yes. Yeah, a ton of potential. But it's plus, we don't know all of his powers and what he can do. Like,
It almost feels like after next issue, when he finally fights the Hulk, that we're finally going to get into it and get into who Scar is and the story of his own. So, we'll see. Okay, let's move on. Talk about Sea Guy, Slaves of Mickey Eye, number 3. I've been a big proponent of the series.
You have. And the first two issues, I was like, with this one, I get it. It makes sense. It was enjoyable.
I'm so excited.
I know.
I feel like I have given birth to a baby that you finally like.
Yeah, because I hated all your other babies.
That's what I'm saying.
Anyways... This wasn't like Grant Morrison being like, I'm fucking with your head and you're trying to figure it out. And no, this is like, okay, we get it. You know, Mickey Eye is this evil thing and he, you know, plays with humans and we're all puppets. And all right, fine, cool. And Sea Guy's going to save us. And it was just like some great moments, fun, and like still had some trippy stuff. It wasn't as trippy as the first two issues. But I felt like with this last issue, he had an agenda. So he couldn't just be trippy for trippy's sake. But what I did enjoy, like, there was the fight sequence at the end was really very enjoyable.
The thing that I love most about the series is that, and the series before it, is that Sea Guy is a hero without ever actually really doing anything heroic other than being himself. It's kind of cute.
Cool.
He's just himself, and he inspires people. And that's the essence of a hero. And you know what Grant Morrison does best is bring the idea of superheroes down to their essence, and he really does it here as well. It's fun, it's funny, It's creative. It's an enjoyable world that I can't wait to get back to again.
Yeah, and it makes you never want to go to Disney World.
Yeah, never. All right, last but not least, let's talk about Black Panther number 5. I think we're probably going to spoil this a little bit, so if you don't want Black Panther spoiled for you at all, tune out, I guess. What did you think about this?
Well, yeah, I feel like you should go first because I'm curious to hear your thoughts on it.
Well, here's the thing. I have loved what Reginald Hudlin actually has done with Black Panther up until this reboot. Yeah. Up until this reboot, which is driving me nuts because it really feels like it's a marketing-driven thing of like, oh, Black Panther wasn't doing enough sales. Let's reboot it with a sexy female in the lead, except let's also take 6 issues to get her to the point where she's the lead. What we're finally getting in this issue, at least, is a little bit of Hudlin's humor, which is the thing that I liked about it. There's 1 or 2 funny parts, but they're few and far between. The thing that made me so angry here, and I know they're going to figure out a way out of it, but essentially the Black Panther is at death's door. Storm has made this deal where she is basically like, I will trade my soul for the soul of the Black Panther because you are more important, and you are the only person that can stop Morlun, the demonic totem guy from the Spider-Man JMS arcs that everybody loved, and I say that sarcastically, who has come back to try to destroy Wakanda. The crazy thing about that to me, I understand Storm's doing it because she loves Black Panther, but like, Storm is a fucking badass who could beat up Morlun on her own, and it's totally unnecessary to be like, woman less important than that.
No, alright. Because she explains it by saying, you're more important to Wakanda than I am to it. Which is true.
Well, I mean, what can I do about that?
All right, first of all, I kind of agree with you. Like, back Black Panther, Jason Aaron was doing it for a little bit, and it was amazing. And recently, it was really well done. I haven't liked Black Panther as much in a really long time. I feel like these last couple of issues have been weird just because they've been like, there's a new Black Panther. No, not really. I mean, the old Black Panther's just in limbo. And what's interesting about the whole limbo thing is, like, you know, it's all about sacrifice and, like, people putting things, you know, for a cause. You know, like we were talking about the definition of a hero and being able to put yourself in front of other people, like Storm did. And I just feel like, and there was a lot of jokes and making fun about, like, army, military, and, like, old school voodoo and magic and stuff like that. But I feel like this, it's going to get somewhere. Right now it's a little bit like this, but I feel like the series
I just want to get past this first arc. I feel like, you know, this is another thing that we talk about on the show a lot, but I think numbering and names and things like that, and if this was an arc in Black Panther, it was called, like, the death of the Black Panther or something like that, I feel like there would be a lot less pressure on it in a certain way. It would be more of an event, because it would be, oh man, the death of the Black Panther, what's going to happen? But there would be less pressure because it would be part of the regular series. It would feel like, okay, this is an arc of the regular series, rather than launching an all-new franchise, so to speak.
Yeah. I don't think Black Panther is going to end up being that girl.
One last thing. If you get the cover that Pete got, you will get Storm's butt. They actually forgot to edit out her butt cheeks on there, so that's pretty exciting for you personally.
I don't think they forgot to edit out. The artist was like, I want to show as much buns as possible.
Buns?
I don't know if there's a variant cover for that, but
there's a variant cover that shows her badge.
Oh my god. But yeah, Black Panther's been very
interesting. Black Panther, if you will.
Oh boy.
Her T'Challa. No.
I don't know what's going on, but it's very
interesting. Yeah, would you say pick this up?
Yeah. I would say buy it.
You wanna pick that up?
I wanna buy it.
You wanna pick up her Black Panther? If you have a question for us, you can write us at comicbookclublive@gmail.com, our new email address. You can check out our blog, popcultureshock.com/cbclub. Check us out on iTunes, Comic Book Club Live, and
if you're ever in New York City on Tuesday night, 8 o'clock, People's Improv Theater, we do a live show. You can win $25. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's great. Hey, you think she likes putting rubber in?